Hello everyone. Objective of this tutorial is to learn web tables in Selenium. So in this video, we are going to discuss about what is web table, types of web table, and a complete example to access values from web table. Okay. So first, let me tell you what is web table. A web table is a HTML structure for creating rows and columns on a web page. In HTML, table is created using table tag, and it contains three things: header, which is created using th tag; rows, which is created using tr tag; and columns, which is created using td tag. So I can say headings of the table are created using th tag, and the rest of the columns are created using td tag. Okay. Generally, we can see on web page there are two types of web tables. First one is static web table, when number of rows and columns are always constant or predefined. For example, calendar, which contain weeks and days, etc. So in calendar, weeks and days are already predefined. And another type of web table is dynamic table, when the number of rows and columns will be dynamic. It will be keep on increasing or decreasing based on the data updated. For example, employees database, or I can say Facebook user database, etc. As we know that every second users are increasing in Facebook, so I can say Facebook user database is updating every seconds. So it's a dynamic table of Facebook users database. Okay. First, let's see about static web tables. So this is my dummy web page, in which we have table that contains 4 rows and 3 columns. And this is the HTML code of my dummy page. So when the number of rows and columns are fixed, we can locate the cells using row and column numbers. Okay, so this is one thing. Now let's go to script side. So here we will use XPath to get the inner text of the 7 cell containing the text. So this is the XPath of 7 cell in HTML table. Let's say this cell, which is having value Peter. We can see the syntax of XPath: double slash table at the rate name equal book table, then 1 slash tbody slash tr3th. So in XPath, we can see first step is to set the parent element. Here XPath locator in web drive always start with a double forward slash and then followed by the parent element. So here parent element is table, whose name is book table. Then second step is to add the child element. The element immediately under table tag is tbody. So we can say that tbody is the child of table. The tbody tag is used to group the body contents in an HTML table. So all the child elements in XPath are placed after their parent element, separated with one forward slash, like this way. After that, we have third step is to add predicates. The tbody element contains 4 tr tags. Here tr tag creates rows in the table. We can now say that these 4 tr tags are children of tbody, or we can say that these 4 tr elements are siblings. Siblings refer to child elements having the same parent. Now let's say I want to access third row. For that I can mention TR3 inside the bracket. Predicates are number or HTML attributes enclosed in a pair of square bracket. If we don't mention any predicates like only TR, no bracket and no number, then XPath will access the first sibling by default. Okay, after TR3, the next child element we need to access is the TD tag. Please note that XPath of the table heading is different and we have TH instead of TD. TH represents heading row, means TH tag will give list of columns for the heading row only. Below heading row, all are considered as TD. So let us consider TR3 is third row, which contains 3 TD tags. Please note TD tag, not TH tag, as it is not heading of the table. Now I want to access first column of the third row. For that I will mention TD1, or no need to mention 1. As I told, if we are not mentioning any number, XPath will access the first sibling by default. So after mentioning TD, now we have the correct XPath locator, complete XPath locator, which is first column from third row, means 7th cell in the table. And to get the text from the 7th cell, we need to add dot get text method like this. Okay, and suppose if we are using nested tables, for that we need to write XPath like this. First outer table, then inner table. Okay, so this is the complete script to find the value of 7th cell from web table. And here is the output of the script that you can also check on your console once you run this script. Okay, so this is all about static table. Whatever we discussed till now, it is best suitable for the tables which does not change its dimensions and it always remains the same. So after static tables, let's move to dynamic tables. Means number of rows and columns will be dynamic. It will be keep on increasing or decreasing based on data. To handle these type of situations, we need to use a different algorithm. Okay, so for that, first we need to get the entire HTML table and store this in a variable, for example, dtable of type fav element, like this. This is the syntax. Okay, then we need to get all the rows from HTML table and store all the elements in a list of web element. So we can see in this syntax, all the elements with tag tr are stored in row list. Okay, so this is about rows. Similarly, to get all the columns from HTML table, we need to store all the elements into a list of web element. For example, I want to get column details of first row, heading row. So for that, this method row.get0 will give first row, and here we have used tag name of column TH, as TH represents the heading row only. It will give list of columns for the heading row. So once this is done, we can get the values of the cells. So here I am going to print the heading. As the heading is the first row, we have simply used the printing of columns by looping. Here we are not looping for the rows because we are printing only first row, heading row. So here looping for rows are not required. So this is a complete script to print the values from first row from web table. In this example, I am printing first row, or I can say heading row, from static table. And here is the output of that script that you can also check on console once you run this script. So in script, we can see whatever we discussed. So here I will get all the rows from HTML table, and then I will print the number of rows including heading row also. Okay, how we get the number of rows? We can get through rows.size method. Similarly, we will get all the columns from HTML table, and here also we will count the number of columns with the help of size method. Then this is the for loop, whatever I told you, and here I am printing all the values from first row using getText method. Okay, so here we are printing only one row. Let's say I want to print the value of another row, for example second row or third row, or I want to print more than one row. So for that we need to do looping for rows also. For example, I want to print all the values from second, third and fourth row. For that this is the code. So here first we need to get all the rows from HTML table and store all the elements from that row into a list. Similarly, we need to get all the column details from second row to last row and store all the elements into a list of web elements. We can see here we are running loop from second row to last row to get all the rows details. Then inside row loop we are again running loop for columns to print all the values using getText method. So this is the output that you can see on console once you run this script. Okay, so this is about dynamic web tables. So in this video we have discussed about static and dynamic web tables. So we can say handling of tables on web page is not so difficult. All what we need to do is to just check the table cell and get the HTML location of these tables. In most cases, tables contains text data, and we can simply extract that data given in each row or column of the table using getText method. But sometimes tables have links or images as well. So for that also we can easily able to perform any action on those elements if we can find the HTML location of the containing cell. For example, if we want to click on that link or image in web table, for that we need to just use dot click method in place of dot get method like this. So through this click method we can easily click on any link or images in web table. So this is all about web tables. I hope you understand the concept of web tables, and I hope you like this video. So thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe.